Good morning, student. Myself Kehar Singh from Jyoti Academy. Today we will discuss class 9, subject SST Economics, chapter 2, Pupil as a Resource. So today we will discuss economic activities. Economic activities are basically those type of activities, those are earn something, means where some income and any economic or monetary earning are coming. For example, pulling cycle rickshaw, selling vegetable, factories, worker, bank are economic activities where anything are coming in the monetary form or in the money form, that is called economic activities. Thereafter, activities undertaken in primary, secondary and tertiary. Economic can be categorized in three sectors: primary, secondary and tertiary sector. Primary sectors are those type of sectors, those type of activities, those have been involved in the agriculture, poultry farming, mining, fishing, means those have been depend on the natural resources or the where the anything that have been taken for that particular uses. Thereafter, secondary sectors, these activities are associated with transforming raw material or primary product into commodity useful to man. It will be basically the transformation, means convertibility, raw material converted to finished good. All those activities are coming in the secondary sectors. Thereafter, tertiary sector. Tertiary sector are basically those type of sectors where education plays very important role for the human survival. So these activities are essential for modern factories, a big way. Are termed as tertiary sector: trading, banking, health sector, education sector, insurance sector, all are the tertiary sector's activity. Thereafter, economic activities means give some income, where the income have been coming. And economic activities are primary sector, agriculture farming, agricultural farmer, farming, mining. Thereafter, the secondary sector are raw material transformation to any commodities. Thereafter, the economic activities are third type is tertiary sector, banking, education, health sector, insurance sector. Thereafter, why are women employed in low paid work? Why the women have been provided very less amount of money? The following reason have been given below. The one of the most important reason is the woman is not more educated. Thereafter, the society thinks if the education have been very less, why if we have been given the money, then why we not pay to the men? That's why the people have been pay very less amount of money. Thereafter, skill is also an important determinant. Skill is not available to more and more skilled women is not available, not present. Thereafter, they have been not given a very big amount of money. And it is also a fact women cannot do as much physical work as men. Women can not more stronger in comparison of men. That's why this is one of the most important reasons. So women have been paid very less amount of money. Women have generally an additional responsibility. Women have been fulfill the responsibility of family, their children, so they cannot be as regular duties as compared to men. That's why the women have been pay very less amount of money. So women employed low paid work, they have been different reason: low education, no skills have been present, no physical work compared to men. Women have been not more stronger in comparison to men. People, the society think that they women cannot do more and more perfect work. That's why they have been not provide very good amount of money. Thereafter, some additional responsibility of family, they can fulfill the responsibility of family, children. That's why as a mother, as a wife, as a the different types of social responsibility, that's why women have been not given so amount of money. Thank you very much.